Hello everyone, this is Ambali Bhattacharya Datta. I am a Gurgaon based artist and an art illustrator. Today, in collaboration with Art Lounge, I am going to illustrate how to paint the skin with watercolor to achieve the lifelike three-dimensional effect. Whether you are an amateur or practicing for years, painting skin tones in watercolor can be intimidating. Because I have seen in my workshops, people struggle to choose the right pigments for specific skin tones. Sometimes they struggle to achieve the desired smoothness of the skin because of many hard lines. So by using these few tips that I'm going to share with you all today and in my upcoming videos, you will learn the basics of doing the skin with watercolor. Remember, these are the tips that you need to follow, and I am going to illustrate the process in my videos. But to reach the perfection, practicing every day is the key. So if you want to improve your portraits, make sure you make at least one portrait every day, and that's the secret. So today we are going to paint the skin of an Indian woman who has warm skin tone and has a very smooth skin surface, almost with no wrinkles except the few areas around the eye. So let's get started. So to achieve a realistic skin tone, we need to understand the local color of the skin. Local color means the natural color of any object unmodified by any external light or shadow. Like the local color of the orange is orange, but the local color of the sky is not blue. The color of the sky is always defined by the presence or the absence of the sunlight. It is always better to read your subject for a few minutes and clear your thoughts. So this lady has brown skin tone, so the local color of her skin is brown. To achieve the smoothness of the skin, I am doing weight on weight technique. This technique helps to bleed the color nicely and does not leave any hard lines. We need to remember, we will not use too many colors in one go. We need to work on layers to achieve the intensity. Through weight on weight techniques, the transitions in between layers also happen very smoothly. Coming back to the skin tone, this lady has warm brown skin tone. One thing we need to remember, that painting a warm skin tone only with too many warm pigments like orange, sienna, yellow ochre or warm red can make the skin look flat and dead. To achieve the lifelike effect and the three-dimensional effect, we need to choose the pigments wisely. We need to balance between the warm and the cooler skin tone. Like the warm skin look much more realistic with purplish or bluish darker value of the local skin color. We need to understand it is the light that defines the skin color, and the local color of the skin reacts to the light. So whatever pigment we use, we need to be careful that the base color of the skin need to remain consistent, and the changes that happens, all the changes, you know, that happen because of the light are the changes of the value of the color. We need to remember, watercolor looks lighter once it is dried. So when you are adding the layers to intensify, you need to remember this fact and work accordingly. The key is to work on layers. The common mistake people do is to add black to make it darker, and the result is a complete disaster. Same way, using the white pigment while doing the skin tone can make the subject look very flat due to the loss of translucency. You can water down the intensity of the color. You want lighter tone, you add more water, and that's the way to do it. So it doesn't matter that you want to paint the blue layer first or the other layer first. I prefer start with orange or yellow ochre, as the pigment is little more opaque than the others and it's perfect for warm skin as undertone. So there is a detail of the pigments that I have used at the end of the video. You can pause the video at the end and have a look of the detail palette that I have used. So I have used Winsor Newton watercolor for this painting, and brush is Escoda, and the paper I have used, that is 300 GSM Arches cold pressed. Cold pressed papers are very nice. So this is the final painting. You can see that there is a warm tone, there is a cooler tone this side, and this is the area where the light is hitting the face, and you can see the transition from here to this side and how the skin tone has been done. So I have not shown any kind of detail of the facial elements like the eyes or nose. In this video I have only done the skin tones, and hopefully in the next videos I'll cover the eyes area, eyes or the nose or the other facial elements. If you have any question, you can always ask me. Thank you so much for watching.